the realm of your word of wisdom that agenda supernatural breakthrough, thereby drawing multitude into this church. Pray the prayer from the depth of your heart. Pray the prayer. Lifting your voice, let God hear your voice of intercession. And let this morning, lift up your voice, lift up your voice, lift up your voice. Pray. Be committed to this prayer this morning. Remember, wisdom is the principal thing. Lift up your voice and let's pray for God's word, the reign of his word, the reign of his word, the reign of his word. Let's pray desperately this morning. Remember, he only pours water on the one that is thirsty. Oh God, send us the rain of your word of wisdom, that agenda, supernatural breakthrough, thereby drawing multitude into this church. Father, in the name of Jesus, send us the rain of your word of wisdom, that agenda, supernatural breakthrough, thereby drawing multitude into this church. Father, in the name of Jesus, send us the rain of your word of wisdom, that agenda, supernatural breakthrough, thereby drawing multitude into this church. Father, send us the rain of your word of wisdom in the name of Jesus. Father, send us the rain of your word of wisdom. Lift up a voice, pray for the rain of God's word, the rain of God's word, the word of wisdom, God's word of wisdom, that agenda, supernatural breakthrough, thereby drawing multitude into this church. Oh God, heaven on earth order of the reign of the word of wisdom. In the name of Jesus, let us pray the prayer. Pray the prayer. Pray in the spirit. And let this morning lift up a voice. Pray in the spirit. Pray in your understanding. Pray, 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 pray. Lift up a voice. Pray fervently. Pray with desperation. And let this morning, let God hear your voice in the house of the Lord. This morning, don't keep quiet. Pray the prayer. Lift up a voice. Pray fervently. We give you glory. Lift up your hands to heaven. Wave it to him. Give God prayer this morning for answer prayer. In Jesus' precious name. Please be seated.
Heaven on earth. Shortly, we're going to be rising up again to pray. And when we rise, we're going to be praying this wise. Father, in the name of Jesus, let every installation of hell against the continuous growth of this church be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. We're taking our bearing from Revelation chapter 12, verse 11. It says, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto the death. Without understanding, let's rise up this morning, begin to pray that prayer from the depth of heart. Lift up your voice to heaven and begin to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, let every installation of hell against the continuous growth of this church be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Every installation of hell against the continuous growth of this church, let it be destroyed by the blood of the everlasting covenant. Is somebody praying that prayer at all? Lift up your voice to heaven and begin to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, let every installation of hell against the continuous growth of this church be destroyed by the blood of the everlasting covenant, the blood of Jesus. He said, and overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. We overcome every installation of hell, finding expression in every form of deception, every form of misrepresentation, every form of tradition, every form of misunderstanding. Lord, let it be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, let every installation of hell against the continuous growth of this church be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Is somebody praying at all? Lift up your voice to heaven and pray. Remember, we serve a prayer answering God. Lord, let it be every installation of hell, every manifestation of the installations from the pit of hell against the continuous growth of this church. Father, let it be destroyed by the blood this morning. Let it be destroyed by the blood of the covenant this morning. Is somebody praying at all? Lift up your voice. Pray with understanding. Yes, we are turning to our stronghold this morning, the stronghold of the blood of the Lamb. Father, in the name of Jesus, let every installation of hell against the continuous growth of this church be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Is somebody praying at all? Pray with understanding. Pray with fervency. Pray with faith in your heart. Understanding the fact that when we call upon him, he said he will hear us, he will answer us. Father, let every installation of hell against the continuous growth of this church be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. We ask in the name of Jesus. We ask in the name of Jesus, Father, see to it that every installation of hell against the continuous growth of this church, let it be leveled. Let it be cleared off by the blood of Jesus. Lift up your voice. Ensure that your voice is registered in heaven this morning. Lift up your voice and pray. Cry unto your heavenly Father. He said, when we call upon him, he said he will answer us. Father, we ask that in the name that is above every other name, let every installation of hell against the continuous growth of this church be destroyed by the blood in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and do it. You have been doing that in time past. Lord, you will still do it again. For the power of the just is like a shining light that shineth more and more, even unto a perfect day. Is somebody praying at all? Is somebody praying at all? Is somebody traveling at all? Lift up your voice and pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, let every installation of hell against the continuous growth of this church, let it be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Lift up your voice and cry to your heavenly Father. Pray your understanding and pray in the language of the Holy Ghost. Pray in the language of the Holy Ghost this morning. Father, let it be. Ensure that every installation of hell finding expression in deception, in misrepresentation, in tradition, in misunderstanding, against the continuous growth of this church, let it be destroyed by the blood this morning. Lift up your voice. Begin to magnify his name. Begin to glorify his majesty. Because we serve a prayer answering God. Father, we thank you for hearing our prayers again this morning. To you be all the glory and praise. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. You may please be seated.
Heaven on earth, tomorrow again is that great gathering of the saints. We are going to be praying for Sunday service. We'll be crying unto God in this manner. We will say, Father, in the name of Jesus, let there be instant healings and diverse miracles in our service tomorrow, thereby establishing multitudes in the faith. Remember in Acts chapter 5, verse 12, it says, and by the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people, they all there in one accord in Solomon's porch. And the consequence was in verse 14, you know, believers were the more added to the Lord, multitude both of men and women. Can we therefore rise up on our feet? Let's begin to pray unto our Father regarding tomorrow's service. It's another day, it's another thing. We have never seen that like that before. Our Father, in the name of Jesus, let there be instant healings and diverse miracles in our services tomorrow, thereby establishing multitudes in the faith. In the name of Jesus Christ, tomorrow is a day that we have never seen before. Another great day in his presence. I want you to begin to say, to decree with everything inside of your heart. Make sure you are praying from the depth of your heart. Make sure you are praying from the depth of your heart. Tomorrow is that special day when God is going to turn captivity. Let's begin to pray unto God, saying, Father, in the name of Jesus, let there be instant healings and diverse miracles. Let there be instant healings and diverse miracles in all of our services tomorrow, beginning from the first service unto the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth. Let your manifest presence, as the word of the Lord, will be declared by your servant. In the name of Jesus, we pray, let there be instant healings and diverse miracles
in all of our services tomorrow, thereby establishing multitudes in the faith, in the name of Jesus Christ. Make sure you are praying for this great gathering, the type we have never seen before. The Lord God Almighty, we pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Let there be instant healings and diverse miracles. Let there be sudden outbursts of noise of joy in various corners, in various arms of faith tabernacle tomorrow, as the word of the Lord begin to hit the people, meeting them at their point of need. Mighty God, in the name of Jesus, let there be instant healings, diverse miracles. Let no sickness or oppression of the devil escape tomorrow's service, in the name of Jesus. And do it in all of the services, from the first to the fifth. Mighty God, and as you did of old with the apostles, let the multitude be established in the faith, in the name of Jesus. As you wrought special miracles, diverse and wonders by the hand of the apostle over this commission, we ask, mighty God, you will be have caused the believers to be established in the name of Jesus Christ. As you wrought special miracles through the hand of your servant, the apostle, over this commission in tomorrow's service, we pray, mighty God, let there be instant healings, the type we have never seen before. Let there be eruption of joy in every arm of faith tabernacle, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let there be commotion of joy by virtue of the diverse miracles, in the name of Jesus Christ. And by those special healings and diverse miracles, mighty God, establish the multitude in the faith at faith tabernacle. Establish multitude in the faith, in the name of Jesus Christ. I hope you are praying. Are you praying not mortally what? Are you praying from the depth of your heart? Our Lord and our God, we thank you. Begin to appreciate him. Give quality thanks to this God. Tomorrow's service is going to be like we have never seen before, because we have prayed in the name of Jesus Christ. Please, let's get ready.
Heaven and earth, shortly we shall be rising up to pray, and we're praying along these lines. Father, in the name of Jesus, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind across our territories, drafting multitudes into our services tomorrow. Numbers 11 and verse number 31. And there went forth a wind from the Lord, and brought quails from the sea, and let them fall by the camp, as it were this journey on this side, and as it were this journey on this other side, round about the camp, and as it were 2 cubits high upon the face of the earth. That same wind shall be coming down as we pray. Let's rise up on our feet, therefore, and pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind across our territories, drafting multitudes into our services tomorrow. Let's lift up our voice and call for that wind in the name of Jesus Christ, our prayer access code. Lift up your voice. Father, in the name of Jesus, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind across our territories, drafting multitudes into our services tomorrow, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray this morning, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind across our territories, Lagos, Utah, and environs, drafting multitudes into our services tomorrow. Lift up your voice and let's continue that prayer in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, in the name of Jesus, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind across our territories, drafting multitudes into our services tomorrow, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray that prayer. Holy Ghost, our eyes are on you as you come down, drafting in multitudes, blowing all across our territories in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, therefore we ask in the name of Jesus, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind across our territories, drafting multitudes into our services even tomorrow. In all the five services, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind in all our five services. Let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind. Lift up your voice and let's pray that prayer together. Father, in the name of Jesus, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind across our territories, drafting multitudes, unprecedented multitudes, into all our services tomorrow. In the mighty name of Jesus, let's lift up our voice and let's speak to our Father, our prayer answering God. Father, in the name of Jesus, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind, drafting multitudes into our services tomorrow. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray even this morning, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind. Let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind. Lift up your voice, pray your understanding, pray in the Spirit, ask the Holy Ghost to connect and begin to draft in multitudes into all our services tomorrow, as we ask the Father to release the Holy Ghost coming down as a wind from the Lord, drafting in multitudes, blowing in multitudes in all our territories, in Lagos, Ota, and environs, drafting in unprecedented multitudes into all our services tomorrow in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray, engage your heart even this morning in this prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind. Let the Holy Ghost come down as a mighty rushing wind, drafting in multitudes from across our territories into our services tomorrow, bringing unprecedented attendance tomorrow. Lift up your voice. Let's begin to appreciate Him. Let's begin to appreciate the Father who has released the Holy Ghost already into every nook and cranny of our territories, drafting in multitudes. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let's put our hands together and please be seated.
Heaven on earth. In a moment, we'll be rising up to pray along these lines, saying, Father, in the name of Jesus, send forth your reaper angels to wait upon all our new converts and new worshipers to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Jesus praying in Matthew 26 and verse 53, he said, thinkest thou that I cannot now pray to my Father, and he shall presently give me more than 12 legions of angels? Stand with me to your feet. Let's lift up our voices to heaven, even as we call on our Father in the name of Jesus, to send forth his reaper angels to wait upon all our new converts and new worshipers to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Father, in the name of Jesus, send forth your reaper angels. Send forth your reaper angels, Lord, in their legions, to wait upon all our new converts, to wait upon all our new worshipers, to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Let your angels get them up, Lord Almighty, early, 4 a.m., 5 a.m. Get them set, get them dressed, get them prepared, and get them into the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Lift up your voice to heaven. Lift up your voice to heaven. And let's ask for the ministry of reaper angels to wait upon all our new converts and new worshipers to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday, in the name of Jesus. Remember, we are using our prayer access code, the name that is above every other name, the name Jesus. We are saying, Father, in the name of Jesus, send forth your reaper angels. Send them forth into the nooks and crannies. Send them forth into the highways and hedges. Send them forth into Lagos, Ota, and environs, and even regions beyond, to wait upon all our new converts and new worshipers to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this
Sunday, Lord God Almighty, we call on you. We call on you to release your reaper angels. Our Father, release your reaper angels to wait upon all our new converts and new worshipers to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Is someone praying? Lift your voice to heaven and let's call upon our Father. The angels hearken to the voice of his commandment. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice to heaven and let's ask for the release of reaper angels into the harvest field. All our new converts, all our new worshipers. Father, in the name of Jesus, send forth your reaper angels to wait upon all our new converts and new worshipers to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Lord God of heaven, release your reaper angels. Release your reaper angels. We call on you in the name of Jesus to send forth your reaper angels to wait upon all our new converts, to wait upon all our new worshipers, to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Father, send forth your reaper angels in the name of Jesus Christ. Send forth your reaper angels in the name of Jesus Christ. And command them to wait upon all our new converts, upon all our new worshipers, to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Lord Almighty, let the reaper angels wake them up early and get them set and mobilize them into the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Lord God Almighty, Father, in the name of Jesus, send forth your reaper angels to wait upon all our new converts and new worshipers to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Is someone praying? Lift your voice to heaven. Let's call on our Father, asking that he sends forth reaper angels. He sends forth reaper angels in their legions, wherever our new converts are, wherever our new worshipers are, all across Lagos, Ota, and environs. Father, in the name of Jesus, send forth your reaper angels to wait upon all our new converts and new worshipers to ensure their presence at the Faith Tabernacle this Sunday. Somebody give thanks to God. Let's give thanks to God, for he has heard and he has answered. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Please, let's be seated.
Heaven on earth, right now it's time for personal supplication. Personal supplication. We're going to be going before the Lord, those issues of your life where you desire from God breakthroughs this morning. You'll take it to God in prayer. And remember, you are also free to pray for the advancement of the kingdom. And remember also others who may be in need that you are aware of. Take them to God in prayer. Please rise up on your feet right now. Lift up your voice unto the Lord and begin to call upon his name for the next few minutes that we have. Begin to pray and pour out your soul unto God. And please pray in your understanding and pray in faith using the name of Jesus Christ. Personal supplication. We serve a prayer answering God. Let him hear your voice this morning. Take advantage of this dew of the morning. Begin to pour out your soul unto God. God is here for you today. Pray the prayer that God must answer even now. Don't just pray into the future. Pray the prayer that God must answer even this morning. You must return with a change of story. Pray fervently. Pray with every intent and purpose. 2 more minutes to go. Lift up your voice to the Lord. Don't let this moment pass you by. Like the blind Bartimaeus, cry unto God. And like Jacob did, I won't let you go until you bless me. This week is over. In the next few hours, I won't let you go, Jesus, except you change my story. Cry unto the Lord and pour out your soul. In a moment, you must return today with a change of story. Let's begin to give thanks unto the Lord right now for answered prayers. Lift up your voice. Thank him. Lift up your hands. Wave it to the Lord. Magnify his name. We serve a prayer answering God. Father, I thank you. Father, I praise you. Is somebody thanking the Lord? Is God hearing your voice of appreciation? God has done it already. Magnify his name. Father, we give you praise and glory. Thank you for answered prayers. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Shout aloud, amen. Please be seated.
Heaven on earth, people of God, it is testimony time. Please listen to the following documented testimonies and be blessed. Number one, 2 years abandoned shops rented. I want to appreciate the God of Bishop David Oyedepo for what he did in my life during this Wonder Double prophetic agenda. Immediately the 7 weeks of Wonder Double was announced, I keyed myself into it and I believed God for my desired testimony. During one of the Sunday services, God's servant said that if we can make God's business our priority, God will make our own concerns too his priority. When I heard this, I believed that putting this word to work will birth my test asked for. As soon as I started praying kingdom promotion prayers, a man came to ask for the shop and paid for a year's rent. Before I knew what was happening, 5 shops out of 6 were already rented. Also, my home cell is doubled. Praise the Lord. Deaconess Oladipupo T. Number 2, divine favor. Heaven on earth, I have returned to give thanks to the God of my own sent prophet, Papa Bishop David Oyedepo, who gives favor even before I ever ask. All through the week, I was financially low, up to the extent that I could barely get first to my place of work, which I just got as I was being owed arrears of salaries from my previous job. Even on Sunday of the banquet service of divine favor, my wife and I had to take a long trek early that morning to a spot where I knew we would be able to get a free ride to church because I couldn't afford to miss a service. During the covenant hour of prayers on Tuesday, Papa proclaimed, "We are in our week of favor, that all we need to do is to take out at least 15 minutes to pray kingdom advancement prayers, especially for all our new converts." But after the service, I told my wife we will take our 30 minutes every day. Brethren, we are even yet to commence the prayers. Same day,
I received a full credit alert from my previous place of job, where I least thought of as the barely ever pay salary so early. Now, I can even extend the prayers to 1 hour daily. I give God thanks. Alexander, oh, would you rise up and lift your hands and celebrate the God of heaven who has done all these great wonders. Give him praise. Magnify him. Exalt him.
our two hands to heaven one more time and celebrate this prayer answering God. Let's appreciate Him for this life quickening platform where we hear from Him daily, where we behold the testimonies of the Lord in the life of His people. Magnify Him and thank Him for your own testimonies. Thank Him for your own testimonies. Thank Him for your own encounters. Thank Him for answers to your own prayers. In the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise the Lord. It is very clear that every move of God moves people forward, particularly those who are bona fide partakers of that move, those who are bona fide, you know, engagers in that move. And what I'm saying is this: it is your season of going forward. Amen. It is your season of going forward. Amen. Therefore, grace to remain a partaker of this move. Go ahead, receive it right now. God, I receive grace to be a bona fide partaker of this move. Grace to be listed among the ark bearers. Grace to be part of this great move of the Spirit. I receive that today. I refuse to be an onlooker. I refuse to be a commentator. Lord, grace to be a major player in this great move. I receive it. Come on, go ahead and receive it. 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 Take it from the Lord right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Your involvement and investment may not be seen by man, but God, who sees your involvement, your engagement, and your investment in the secret, He said He will reward you openly. Amen. So one way to know whether we are involved, we are engaged, and we invest are the things that manifest in our lives. All these people giving testimonies, I don't know them. But God saw them. That your heart is set to advance my kingdom, let me open up a new chapter to your life. And simply did. You had to trek long distance with your wife to get across the church. He said, but no, my wife, we are not going to solve 15 minutes, we are going to make 30 minutes. Some forgot that instruction before they left the church. Their heart is not there. Their heart is not near the place. What is 15 minutes for what? With all the needs of my life? After 15 minutes, I'll cry to God on my own needs. They decided that day we are going to make it 30 minutes. And God said, 30 minutes? Okay, I'll open up your future. And He opened up their destiny. The tightness was over the same day. The tightness was over the same day. Testimonies are pointers to our heritage. If your heart is not with God, you can't move His hand. It takes your heart with God to move His hand in your favor. Therefore, that grace you have caught for this morning shall be resident and manifest in your life. Amen. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Please get seated. Engaging the wonders of the prayer altar. What is on the prayer altar for me? The altar of prayer is the altar of encounter with favor. The altar of prayer is the altar of encounter with favor. Hebrews 4:16, which we all know, let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy
and find grace to help in the time of need. Now, listen. Grace simply means divine favor. Now, let's read it. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of divine favor, that we may obtain mercy and find divine favor to help in the time of need. So the altar of prayer is the throne of divine favor. So when we engage what provokes favor in prayers, divine favor flows without sweat. Therefore, as we make God's kingdom a priority in prayers, divine favor flows naturally. Because pray ye first for the advancement, the expansion, the enlargement of the kingdom of God, and all these things that others are dying to get shall be lavished on your life. That's favor. The word seek also interprets pray. He that asketh, receiveth. He that seeketh, findeth. To him that knocketh, the door shall be open. Pray ye first for the kingdom of God and all its demands, and all these things shall be added unto you. But pray ye first. So the prayer that provokes favor is the kingdom advancement, kingdom promotion, kingdom enlargement prayers. For I will arise and have mercy upon Zion, for the time to favor her. Yea, the said time is come. Am I sure I've prayed for favor before that God favor me? When you pray for what moves God to favor people, he'll favor you. Husband and wife just agreed. I can't even remember the name now. Husband and wife agreed that we will make it 30 minutes. Upon the agreement, favor landed. They have not even started. Same day, maybe they had the first session of 30 minutes of praying kingdom advancement prayer, and the people were struggling to trek to church. All their blessings that the enemy has tied down was released. If I don't know anything, I know this is the gateway to the reality of heaven or not in your life. If you like, take it. Like, reject it. We've never had testimonies of Matthew 6:33 like we've had it this year. It pointed to the fact that your testimony is waiting. I said, your testimony is waiting. Your testimony is waiting. I said, your testimony is waiting. Your testimony is waiting. It's a pointer to the fact that your own testimony is waiting. It's a pointer to the fact that your own testimony is waiting. So the altar of prayer is the altar of encounter with favor. Not crying out for favor, but crying out for God and the advancement of his kingdom. And then you have committed his integrity to favor you. Something happened years ago when I discovered the scriptures. A friend of mine said, Brother David, it's time to start praying for a life partner. I said, I don't need that. It's part of what will be added to me. He said, okay. I said, if you like, we can pray for you. He said, let's pray for me. And so we prayed together for him to get a life partner. And God gave to me, not him that we are praying for. He's a humorous God. Just pray for what provokes favor, and favor will flow in your direction. We prayed together for him, and God answered me. Are you hearing what I'm talking about? There's a way you pray kingdom advancement prayer today that your job will land today. Today is Saturday, but it will land. People have gotten jobs here on Sundays. Somebody got a job here on Christmas Day. You get that kind of job? That is the man giving the job has to go to work. No, this man must get his letter today. Bam, 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 bam. Your appointment is 25th of December. This God can do anything if you know the right thing to do. If you know the right thing to do. Now watch it. Now stand in the gap for the service tomorrow. On a very personal note. Everyone hearing me today, both here and all our viewing centers, stand in the gap today and make your own 30 minutes. Nitasu Shane, Enkrobi Alisha Kinoa. Everyone coming in for to worship tomorrow, no distraction. Satan, take your hand off the affairs of everyone ordained to be at the service tomorrow. Angels of God, stay on each one worshiper, each one ordained to be in this service. Old members, new converts, wait on them. Tap them at the exam time to get up. Move them to their bedroom. Get them dressed up. Mobilize them to the bus stops. Get them into their own cars. Move them on their way here. In the name of Jesus. Let your word come down like thunder. Let it shatter and scatter every installation of hell against every destiny. Lord, by your word tomorrow, let every captive be set free. Let no one return from your clinic tomorrow, because Holy Communion service is God's clinic. Let no one return from your clinic tomorrow with any trace of sickness or disease in their lives. Let every oppression of the devil be over. Father, no accidents tomorrow in the name of Jesus. No breakdown of vehicles in the name of Jesus. And you begin to pray. No disappointment of transporters tomorrow. In the name of Jesus. Lord, flow freely by your word tomorrow into every life. Let each one's word come. And you are praying. And God say, oh, I've found someone else to favor. I've found someone else to favor. Someone here is provoking my favor. I have no choice but respond. Somebody here is provoking my favor. I have no choice but respond. That's what brings you into favor with God. Amen. It's not just the author of praying and weeping. Oh God, oh God, oh God, give me again, give me again. Don't forget this one. Get me bread, get me butter, get me tea. I want Lipton tea. No, I don't want that. I want Nescau. Get me a pair of shoes. I want high heel, 4 inches. 1 meter. Glory to God. He said, acquaint now thyself with God and you'll be at peace. Thereby shall good come unto thee. Get to understand how God responds to us. Get to understand how God relates with his people. Get to understand what provokes God to favor his people. Engage in it. Thereby shall good come unto thee. Receive, I pray thee, the law from his mouth and lay up his words in your heart. If you return to the Almighty and begin to operate back according to his desires and his plans, you shall be built up. Then you shall lay up good as dust. That just favor is just flowing. Get to know how God responds to us. Get to know what moves God to favor us. Engage in it and watch what happens in your life. This is your best year till date. Don't let this year pass like any other year. Don't be an onlooker. The Holy Ghost was singing in India. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Lord, I want to be in the number. When the saints go marching in. And I began to sing it. Oh, when the saints go breaking forth. Oh, when the saints go breaking forth, Lord, I want to be in the number. When the saints go breaking forth. This is our time of breaking forth. This is our moment of manifesting the realities of heaven on earth. I still have this iron thing that came out of my son's elbow right on my table. This is heaven's came down operation. What is it? If you don't know about heaven come down, that should help you to know that. Because I've never seen that you will remove that kind of weight from a man's elbow without any opening, without any stitches. That is the Almighty saying, I'm in your midst. Can't you see me? Can't you see I am in your midst?
Can't you see you have no mountain that can stop you? Now, this is our time of breaking forth. Men and women in this church, many will emerge as living angels this year because of their engagement with their God. Glory to God. Amen. Choir, can you put that song together and let's sing it? When the saints go breaking forth, oh Lord, I want to be in the number. I don't want to be an onlooker. I want to be in the number when the saints go breaking forth. Hallelujah.
Oh, when the saints
stand to your feet.
Breaking forth. Oh, when the saints are breaking forth. And Lord, I want to be in the number.
Come on now.
Oh, when the saints are breaking forth. Oh, when the saints, oh, when the saints.
Oh,
when the saints,
oh, when the saints,
oh, marching, Lord, I want to be in the number. Oh, when the saints, oh, marching, oh, marching, say, oh, when the saints,
oh, when the saints,
oh, marching,
oh, marching,
oh, when the saints,
oh, when the saints,
oh, marching, Lord, I want
to be in
the number. Oh, when the saints,
when the saints.
Give the Lord a beer.
Hallelujah. Amen. Please understand, God has vowed to make heaven a reality in your life this year. Yeah. And all you need is to vow to do what will provoke him to do it. And what do? Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things that heaven can afford will become yours. This is your year of testimonies. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. The favor of God will redefine your destiny. Yeah. The favor of God will turn you to the envy of your world. Yeah. The favor of God will change your story forever. Yeah. The favor of God will redefine your life. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now,
I'd like you to understand as you come in for the service tomorrow that you are coming into God's clinic. Where are you coming to? Where are you coming to? He never refers a case. The great physician never refers a case. Look at him all through New Testament. There was no case referred by him. He's the only one that admits the dead in his hospital. He never refers a case, so your case will not be referred. Amen. I don't know what the matter is. I don't know what the doctor's verdict is, but it will be sorted tomorrow. Amen. Help me tell everyone we are inviting with confidence. Come with me to God's clinic. Come with me to what? Come with me to God's clinic. Let him sort you out finally. Come with me to God's clinic and let him sort you out finally. That man from Cameroon was cleared of HIV/AIDS. Boom. Just one shot of that treatment sorted him out. That man was set free from bone marrow cancer once and forever. Tell them the communion service, a special communion service, is God's own special clinic. That's his specialist clinic. That's where you get, that's the ultimate place for your quest for total health, among others. Come and let's put on Christ via the mystery of the communion. Come, let Christ live his life through us in all areas, spirit, soul, and body. That is one service you should advertise with all zeal and pray for. All our combats since the year began, all of them must show up tomorrow. All of them must show up tomorrow. Yeah. All our first-time worshippers who are roaming about the street must show up tomorrow. Yeah. Everyone that God has brought under this prophetic umbrella must show up tomorrow. Yeah. All old members, no one gives himself flimsy excuse. I mean, I just feel unkind. No, you are feeling the devil's kind. Feel unkind from your father's house. No. No negative feelings is permitted. Everyone called by his name under this commission will arrive in church here tomorrow. Amen. You believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. Amen. Glory to God. You must refuse to be an onlooker. The saints will soon be getting decorated. One-star general, two-star general, three-star general, five-star general. God will soon start decorating the saints in return for their engagement. You will not be left behind. You will not be left behind. You will not be left behind. My friends and peers used to say, "Otile Kabra, Debi Laraju." I was there, man, we have other things to do. I didn't have any other thing to do. This is the only thing I was doing. And I wasn't called to minister. Nobody's paying me for nothing, but I could see a future in it. I have caught the vision of Matthew 6:33. It has overwhelmed my life. And it has decorated my life in return. It has decorated my life in return. If I get nothing from it, this sadness of health is enough a testimony. You've been jumping about day and night. You run through five services and you can't feel you have done anything. You still leave that place to go to work again. No. Because it's turned me from being a vegetable to being a lively stone. Man, serving God pays. Serving God's interest pays. Lift up your two hands. And thank God for the privilege to be alive at this time to take advantage of his majestic presence in our midst. To experience the reality of heaven or not in your life, come and give him thanks. I refuse to be an onlooker. I refuse to be a passerby. I refuse to keep watching. I must be a full partaker of this move. I must be a full partaker of this move. So when the saints are marching to their inheritance, marching to their call of inheritance, I will not be watching. When the saints are breaking forth, I will not be breaking down. Oh Lord, I thank you and I receive grace of you today. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name, we have given thanks. Go in peace. Amen. Today is declared a day of divine encounters for you. Amen. The balance of your reserved testimonies for the week arrives today. Amen. As we engage the prayer altar towards the expansion of his kingdom, he continues to lavish his favor on your life. Yeah. Even today, the rain of favor is falling on your life. Yeah. Even from this hour, the rain of favor is falling on your life. Yeah. That favor will bring home your miracle marriage. Yeah. That favor will bring home your marital restoration.
That favor will bring you business breakthrough. That favor will bring you career breakthrough. That favor will bring you family breakthrough. That favor will bring you breakthrough for your children. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Praise God. Aren't you happy to see the last day of the week? Whose doing is that? Say with me, this is the doing of the Lord. And it's marvelous in my eyes. Glory to God. Shall we together share the goodness of the Lord in fellowship, everybody? Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. And we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever. Amen. Peace. Now, get ready for the broadest smile of your life. Are you ready for it? Amen. Everyone seated in heaven laughs. See, if that's where you are seated, you must laugh. If you are not laughing, then you are not there. How many are seated in heavenly places here? Okay, give the Lord a big laugh. Give him a big laugh. Come on, get excited at God. The world is looking for to be like you. Amen. Now, heaven on earth. I'm not asking you to close your eyes. Heaven on earth. Okay, wonders without end. Help me prophesy that to your neighbor right there and congratulate him. That's my new realm and your new realm. Congratulations. That's my new realm and your new realm. Congratulations. Celebrate him.